Good morning, students. Today we are going to study what is the government's role. Government's role in providing public facilities are very much important. In order to meet the people's needs or basic facilities, government plays a very important role. The government relates to the basic needs of the people. The responsibility to provide basic public facility is that of the government. So we can understand that the basic facilities such as the drinking water, house to provide the housing facilities, to provide education, to provide the health facilities, these all are the basic facilities of the people. And to provide such basic facilities is the very important role of the government. Now let us see that from where the government get money for these public facilities. So I have told you that public facilities are provided by the government, or it is the very important role of the government. But from where the government get the money for providing public facilities? The main source of revenue for the government is the taxes collected from the people. So main source of revenue for the government is the taxes collected from the people. Various types of taxes are being collected, and these are the important source of revenue. For example, we can see to supply water. Water supply is one of the essential public facility or very basic need of the people. The government has to incur cost for pumping water, carrying it over long distances for distribution, laying down pipes for distribution, treating the water for impurities, etc. So government, in order to supply the water, government has to incur various costs. For example, pumping water costs are included, carrying it over long distances costs are has to be paid, laying down pipes for distribution some costs are charged, treating the water for impurities again costs are cost has to be paid by the government. So these all costs are the responsibility to carry this cost is to provide water facility, that is upon the government. The government meets expenses partly from the various taxes. So I have told you that the main source of revenue for providing public facilities of the government is the taxes collected from the people. So partly the taxes which give money for government to incur this cost. The taxes which collect and partly by charging a price for water. So according to that, the price of the water to be charged by the government. So cost to be incurred, or various types of cost expenditure to provide the supply of drinking water, which is one of the important function of the government. But for this, the government gets money from the taxes, and according to the cost and according to the basic needs, whichever basic needs are to be provided for the people, then the government charge a price which is very economical, which is very affordable for the people. So government charge a price for water based upon the basic necessity, which should be equally available for everyone, and the taxes which they collect to incur the cost for providing the water. The price is a set that most people can afford a certain minimum amount of water for daily use. So the price which is set by the government, that is based upon the how people can afford, or every section of people can afford it. That economic or reasonable price is set by the government. And As I have told you that the very important source of this public facilities that is, or the income of the government, that is the taxes, and the government charges the price according to the affordability of the people. Now we can see that water supply in Chennai. Water supply in Chennai, as we have discussed before, which in that we could see that every section of people are not available, water is not available to everyone equally. Another thing that some people pay very high prices or high charge for the water and they get it, whereas some areas there is acute shortage of water resource, people have to only depend upon the municipal water or the water provided by the government. So the water supply in Chennai is one of the important case study which is given in your textbook. You can see that various kinds of people, richer people, they have money so they can get the private water supply, but poor people, they cannot afford it. The burden of shortage of water falls mostly on poor. So based on this case study, we can see that everywhere, whatever the shortage or the shortage for basic needs, that basic needs are there, that is actually it falls mostly on the poor. Here we could see the burden of shortage of water, which falls mostly on the poor people, because rich people can afford it. They can collect from the private facilities or private companies, they can collect it, but poor people cannot afford. So the the final burden of shortage of water, that is on poor people. Access to safe drinking water is also available to some people. Another thing that very important conclusion we can arrive from this case study of Chennai, that is access to safe drinking water, means to get the safe drinking water, that is also available to some people. Means those who have money, they can get the safe drinking water. Those who don't have much money, they have to face the problem or shortage of the water. Next thing, that in the urban cities or urban areas, because of the borewells, digging of borewells, etc., digging of borewells, private companies also depend upon the underground water, the underground water table is decreasing. So in Chennai, even we could see underground water table is decreasing because of these borewells or underground water, collecting underground water, the underground water table is decreasing. That is another important conclusion we could arrive by the from the case study of Chennai. And next thing that we can see, the conclusion we can see, or in search of alternatives, we can see that, we can conclude that throughout the world, there are four important facts which are given, or four important facts are given regarding the facilities or regarding the supply of water or public facilities. First one, that throughout the world, water supply is the function of the government. Throughout the world, if we analyze, we can see that water supply is the one of the very important function of the government. Second thing, that is, there are areas in the world where public water supply has achieved universal access. Public water supply has achieved universal access, means it is available to everyone. There are many places where public water supply, with that it is equally given to everyone, or people get it, means every type of people, every kind of people, they get it. Then third thing, that the places where water supply is handled by the private companies, there was huge increase in prices. In some places we could see water supply is handled by the private companies, but if we consider the price of that water, we could see that the price is very high, or price was very high. For example, Bolivia. Bolivia, a place where for some years, private companies started supplying water. So the price was very high, and people started protest against that high price. At last, the water supply was brought back to the control of the government, or it became a public facility, and the private companies stopped the this providing water. So that is one Bolivia's water war, which shows that private companies, when they handle this basic facility such as providing water, it charges very high prices. Next thing, that within India there are various cases of success in government water departments. Hence, in India itself, if we see that government water department, they provide the water universally access to everyone and affordable to everyone. So that success we can see. Though these are few in number, but limited to certain areas of their work. But it is not everywhere we cannot see, but there are few cases we can, or few places we could see that government is successful in providing water to everyone and affordable to everyone. But it is successful. That is why this is one of the important fact we can consider during in our study. So these are the important thing that we have studied in this lesson. That means public facilities is the very important function of the government.